managed to get the storage from your Facebook data by using the Power Query. Let's begin our session. Talking about me, I'm Angan Marzan, and I have more than 5 years of experience in data analytics. Previously, I worked more than 3 years in Verix IT, and then I shifted as a database consultant in my DBA for 3 to 4 months. And then currently, I'm working as a BI engineer at NSAL for more than 2 years. Also, I got selected for PaaS Summit 2014 as a program committee member for BI platform administrative and development. And you can see my blog. I've been posting blogs related to BI and SSS, SSIs, SSIS, SQLs, and Power BI, Hadoop, such kind of things in my blog post. You can go through my blog post also. Also, you can follow me on the Twitter and my LinkedIn address. So today's agenda, I'll be covering, these are topics I'm covering today. Mainly, what is Power BI, what is Power Query, and then what's the Power BI architecture product, and then how can you work with Power BI desktop, and then how to get your data from Facebook, and then analyze, and then visualize, and then find the story behind your Facebook data. Actually, what's a Power BI? In simple terms, Power BI is a Microsoft business intelligence solution, you can say. Mainly it's used to get the more insight from, or useful insight from the data. And then also what we can say is to extract the story behind the data. And then regarding Power Query, it's previously it's adding feature in the Excel 2014, but from Excel 2016, it's already integrated in Excel 2016, so you don't need to download. Mainly it's used for describing, combining, refining data across a wide variety of data sources, such as you can connect to Hadoop, you can connect to Facebook, Twitter, or as you can say, structure, and also semi-structure and unstructured data. So you can analyze it by using a Power Query. So, based on the Gartner, you can see this Microsoft is a top 3 leader in the business intelligence and analytics platforms. What this means is it's a leading top 3 leading visualization tool amongst different variety of tools you can find in the market. So that Tableau, Qlik, and Microsoft are the top 3 leaders. You can see from the picture.
Okay, sure. Yeah. I need for my session.
Moving on to architecture, you can see this is the Power BI 2.0 architecture currently in the market. This part is the data source part. That means you can connect to cloud, Azure, Office, on-premises database, Excel, flat files, and SQL, on-premises SQL, SharePoint. These are the data sources on the left hand side. And then this Power BI desktop is mainly used to analyze and make a report or some kind of thing. You can directly connect to this different variety of data source just to connect, grab the data, and then analyze it and prepare the reports for visualization. After you prepare the reports in the BI desktop, you can publish to Power BI, and then you can show to your end users, that means executives or any customers, or you can say just end users. There are different variety of end users you can see. Also, you can see from desktop, web version, and the mobile version also, you can analyze it. Moving on. This is a Power BI desktop business interface. I will cover this detail in the demo part. And this is the Power Query, which is adding feature on your Excel 2013. So we don't need to add the add-ins in the Excel. Previously, what Microsoft approach is Power Query, you have to download, Power View, you have to download, and Power Map you have to download, and then add in the Excel and do analysis and do visualize and then those things. But now the Microsoft have released Power BI desktop version, which is free. This is Power BI desktop version, which is free, and you can use as a download and then you use as a free tool. So let's start a demo. Now we are going to get the data from our Facebook account, that means your account or any account, your friend's account also, you can, that means grab the data if you have password of your friends also. So this is our Excel, and then previously this is the Power Query add-ins feature. So just go to Power Query and then from other sources. And then this is a, you can see variety of this data source you can connect. So I'm going to use Facebook as a data source. While doing this, it will ask for your user account of Facebook and password. I have already entered this one, so it will directly pop up this screen for me. And then you can see this kind of stuff. That means your Facebook feeds, your friend list in the Facebook, your friends on the Facebook, that means games you have liked, and then comments you have done, everything. That means whatever you do in the Facebook, you can think of as a Facebook. That means there is something in the back end. In every table is stored that means data. So let's do as a feed. You can, I'm grabbing all the feeds of my account. This is the feed. This is the direct live feed from the Facebook. And then you can see last Tuesday back we had celebrated the Holi festival, so I also tweeted in my status as a feed this one. So you can see. You can see this is the feed, and then what is the picture I have posted, what is the picture link, you can see. And then actually this is the first feed, live feed I have got from the Facebook. See, if you copy this link and then go to the browser and then open the browser, you can see this is actually the photo I have posted in the Facebook just to show you days before. So this is a live feed. After getting this data, what you can do is, this is the feed we have just extracted from the Facebook data. Similarly, we have different feed. These are the status, live status I have updated. These are the likes I have done, different things. That means whichever university, whichever like you do, that is page you like. This is like. And these are the posters I have. These are the feeds, similar. And these are the that means music sector, which artists we have liked. That means these are the artists I have liked. So these are the friends I have. Okay, then after you get the data, what you can do is
the users, viewers, as have liked that picture, let's say. I want to get all the information of all those 100 users. Can I get it from this?
Currently, what I have shown here, that is the photo on which 100 likes friends, which are the friends on that.
I want the information of those people who like my picture.
Okay, currently I think that feature is not available. Since you can, while you can see in the source, what you can get from the Facebook is, these are the things only you can get for this. These are things only you can get, that means your stuff only, what you have post, what you have on, like, not in the photos particular, like as you said, currently it's not given by the Facebook. If Facebook allows, then we can grab it. No. But currently that is not possible.
Because you can analyze the potential customers.
Currently that is not possible. So, yes, 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 yes.
Yeah, okay, so
let me see, from the R language,
yeah,
developing Facebook.
So how did you get all the data? Even here you're getting the data. Wouldn't there be permission and privacy issues?
No, no. If you are logging with your user, they will, that means there is no any privacy issue regarding this, since you are logging your account.
That
using
means, there has to be a Facebook that you are logging to.
From the, what we are using is the API to the Facebook from PowerQuery. So the API connection is between Microsoft and the Facebook. So we don't need to concern about the privacy desktop.
You already have the access.
Yes, sir.
The username and password.
Yes, yes. I've already put in, so it's not so. Just a quick demo for the actually, I have shown that from the Power Query perspective, that means it's a old one. That means we have to add the Power Query, Power View, adding to the Excel. But Microsoft has given this Power BI desktop in the free version. So you can use this tool rather than the button. So from here also, you can similarly get data more. What we have done in the Power Query, we can do same exact in the Power BI desktop also. So just connect, just stop, and you come in. Again, they will ask the pop-up screen for your user account and then password. So I've already put them, so it's only like this. Similar stuff, what we just seen in the Power Query side, we are seeing in this Power BI desktop also. So just if you get the feed, this is the live feed, so my test will be on. Similar things, what we have, I have shown in Power Query, these are the same thing. So, if you want to load this, maybe if I get a little time, let's cancel it. I have already loaded the data. And then these are, after we load, these are, this is the feeds that we just reload it. What we can do is, okay, we have already grabbed the feeds from your Facebook account. So in order to find the story behind your Facebook, that the feed we have just extracted, let's do some visualization here. And just drag here. And is that a, can you see it or not? Might be unclear, but what it exactly tells us that I can just copy this. Just another thing. And then you can just change into visualization. What exactly it does is on this, these are the years I have my feed, then how frequently I have posted my feeds, how frequently I like, how frequently I comment, how frequently I add a friends in the Facebook. These are the activities it's showing based on the year. So that you can see on 2008, this is 2008, and so on until 2016. So I use a Facebook. That is so that 2008, I started to use Facebook account. So on 2009, the hype is so much that it's nearly 300, that is activities I have done in 2009, and then it increased on 2010. That means on 2010, I was an engineering student at Canterbury Engineering College. So while in the college, we use a lot of Facebook. So this bar tells that I have done a lot of activities in 2010. So moving on, it goes on decreasing. So now in 2016, I'm not using as much as in 2010. The bar clearly shows us. So similarly, just copy and paste, and then you can see prints like this. Similar thing. What we have done in the bottom, this is a trend. So after doing this visualization, you can post in the Power BI decks, that means Power BI in the cloud portion. So what we can do is just there's a publish button. So if you publish this, it will directly publish to your it will be published to your Power BI. These are the things I have just done in Power BI desktop. So we now, after completing this visualization, we publish in the Power BI, that means web cloud version. So similar things you can see here. And if you, here, what is the benefit is this, you can share this visualization to any end users. That means if your company is developing some kind of a report and you want to share to the marketing, sales, finance, management, such kind of different variety of your, that means end user, then you can just create a role and then share in the cloud version of the BI. So, this is just a simple demo I have shown. What exactly I have done in Facebook related thing is this is a Facebook analysis detail. That means all the data we have just load, that means get from the Facebook. What I have shown you in the Power BI Excel side, there is music I have like, how many friends. This is the friends demographic that means I have 120 friends are female, and then 238 friends are of male. So also, these are the artists I have liked, which shows that Rihanna got
I have liked Rihanna song.
So among these artists, Rihanna is the top one, you can see. So similar things I have done is this one. This is the Facebook activity, that is just what we get exactly the feed from the Facebook. Similar thing. This is until 2014 data, since I have done these things in 2014. So until 2014 only this dashboard has the data. But similar thing, I have shown like this, the feeds. What I have done, added photos, added friend, microphone, created group. These are the different scenarios you can analysis. And this is the trend. From 2008-02, I started the Facebook, and then on 2009, it got hype, and then it's going on, moving on. That means the trend seems going, and then 2014, it goes on decreasing. Also, one interesting thing what I want to show here is on 2009, that means September, the feet get little. That is the feet, this trend on 2009. That means on September, every year on the September, my tweets get this little bit high in the graph. What exactly this tells me that on September 9th, September 4th, that means September month, I have a birthday. That means September 9th, 4th is my birthday, so I get the feeds on my wall, so it gets high. But exactly is what telling is the story behind my Facebook data. You can see this. And then another thing I have done is this one. This is the friendly, that means Facebook friendship analysis. That means how many friends I have added on the entire year. Which on this year, 2008, I have added 28 friends on Facebook. And then 2009, I have added 123. And moving on, 71. As I have already told, this year are my, that is last, that year in the Indian side, so has gone on decreasing. So this one is not supported currently in the Power BI, that is web version, cloud version. But what exactly in here is, I want to show. Little bit then messy, but what exactly it tells that I have added which friends on which date on which particular time. So you can analyze which friend or which girlfriend I have added. Moving on, how many, that means you can, by looking this data, you can say which friend I have added or which particular time. And these are the things. Oh, that means you share something,
no,
and then post
something,
and then your Facebook already again
yeah,
shares
that post, right?
Maybe I have to look at it. Since I haven't looked at data, what we are can you get from the Facebook? So we have to look at that. But that can be a strategy. That is, if we create some business scenario page,
yeah,
and then we share to the public, and then how many is going on loop and loop.
Yeah.
So that it can
let's
be get
something. Maybe you
yes,
yes. Again.
I got the point. What we are trying to say.
We work in a network with like here, share. No?
Yes, yes.
But I want to count
yes,
those
yes.
likes.
So we can see if background. If there is a data in the background, obviously we can do an analysis. So what the feature here is, what the Power BI Cloud version gives a functionality to us is, what after we getting the data and then doing analysis and then making a report and publishing into the cloud, that is Cloud Power BI Cloud version, we can serve this report to our entirely in users like marketing, sales, finance, procurement, and CEO, management, top management, admin. It's a different variety of that means in users. What they can do is just edit the report and do their own analysis. That means if SR wants. Like 2008, only it will reflect that. That is what I mean to what I here I am to go. What here I'm trying to say is that the in-user can do their analysis just by using a drag and drop approach. We don't need to write a query and then send to one thing. And again, marketing guy can give me that data. Again, I have to query and then send again. So it's difficult that same stuff we are doing, that means day by day, in multiple places. So what you can give is just share the whatever data we needed to them, do their own stuff by doing analysis, that means try and drop from their own side. And then whatever they want, they will get it. Actually, the Power BI desktop is a free one, so you can everyone can go and download it and then do analysis of your own. But this Power BI cloud version is your Office 365 account. So if anyone have any company have that account, you can use this Power BI cloud version. Hope you got my demo, what I'm trying to do here. So this is just a demo of what we have shown here. And this is the activity you have there, same thing. And these are the add-ins. You can get Power BI add-ins. If you want to study what is Power BI, you can go there. And then Power BI GXR getting started. This link, it will show entire things, what I have just done here. And then this is a slide here. I have already share this entire thing in the slides here, so you can go there and then download the copy of PDF and do this all the analysis by your own. This is my blog post, you can see. And these are my again blogs, website, Twitter, LinkedIn, so if you have anything, just ask me.